Hi, I've got a special Mac video tutorial for you because I've recently released Torley's WindLight Settings version 2, 240 skies and waters. So if you go ahead and download this, there's only an easy installer for Windows, but don't worry, this zip file is pretty easy too. So after you click that and you can download it, and right here it is on my desktop, and you can download wherever you want, but that's the file. And you can right click and open. By default, it should open and it should unzip. So, oh, here we go. Here's the folder. Whoop, slides over, and I just double click. And inside, here we have water and skies. Now, installing them is a matter of, let's open the hard drive here and let's go to applications. So your Second Life should be here, and you right click and you show the package contents. Now in the contents, just double click to open that up, double click the resources, double click the app settings, and then go into WindLight. Of course, you can also use disclosure triangles or view it in other ways if you like. I like the column view for this. But the key thing is just to get here. So WindLight, right here, skies and water. I'll move this to the side so you can see both sides there. Now we want to go to sky, so we have all these skies, well, not that many, but on this side, if I were to, let's do column mode here too. Okay, you see all these skies now. Wow. I mean, oh, that's the waters. That's not as much. Go up to the skies. Okay. And then, wow, there we go. And you can do command A to select all. I love the shortcuts, you know me, and click and drag them into here and release. And they've gotten into there. And you do the same thing for the water. Okay, so whoop, just make sure, yeah, that's the water. And Command A, and do the same thing for the water. Now, what you want to do to verify that it was installed properly, correctly, is you open Second Life, of course. We're in Second Life now, and just a precautionary note, to get the most effect out of this, you want to go to Edit Menu, Preferences, and in the Graphics tab, make sure Atmospheric Shaders, aka WindLight, is on. If you don't see this, Custom, and there we go, see, and if you select High or Ultra, it will automatically be checked on. You must have a supported graphics card, otherwise it'll be grayed out. All right, so we're all set. World menu, environment settings, and environment editor, and go to advanced sky. And right here, all these skies. Now you can click any one of these like that, for example, and it automatically changes. You can push the down or up arrows to scroll through them and return instantaneous sky change. And it's similar for the water. So please do enjoy these Torley's WindLight settings and feel free to use them for anything. And I'd love if you send me what you make.